you're here. I didn't hear you sneaking up on me. I didn't hear you say anything either. Did you say something? Well, I can't hear a thing. That's because I've got my new invention, Grouch earplugs. I can't hear anything, especially yucky friendly conversations that go on around here.
I told you last night.
You told me what?
Here's something the Grouch shouldn't have to hear. A friendly hello, a friendly goodbye. I bet they're talking about how much they love each other or something.
Well, I told you last night that I have to million things to do today. I got to go uptown. I got to go downtown. I got to go across town for you.
Well, look, I have to get to that meeting, and if I don't take the car, I'll be late. It's as simple as that.
Hey, they don't look like they're saying nice, friendly things to each other.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. You should have just started out earlier.
Look, if we stand out here arguing much longer, then I may as well just forget the whole thing. I'll be late for the whole meeting.
Oh, they look angry. I bet I'm missing a good argument. I better get my earplugs up.
Well, standing out here arguing isn't going to get us anywhere.
That's for sure.
Listen, look, I have an idea. Why don't I take you to the meeting, honey? And then I can run all over and get my errands done. Then I can come back and get you. What do you think? Huh?
Sounds good to me. I don't know. What a silly thing to argue about.
I know.
I'm sorry, honey. I guess this meeting's got me a little on edge.
Yeah, well, yeah. That's okay. But if we keep standing out here, you're still going to be late for your meeting.
Mm-hmm. Let's go. Come on.
Hey, wait. Weren't you just having an argument here?
Yeah, we were, but we made up, Oscar. Bye. See you later.
But I heard that part where you made up. I wanted to hear the argument. And I missed the whole thing.
It's almost ready. My greatest invention. With only three simple working parts. This straight piece here, and another straight piece here, and this cross piece between them. All right? Everything is ready. My great masterpiece is about to be invented. Stand back. I'm throwing the switch. It works. It works. My new invention works. But wait. It has to have a name. I know. I will call it Capital H. Yes, Capital H. And I will use the H in words. Oh, how perfect. Now, let me see. Since the H is heavy, I use it to start the word heavy. And of course, the H is very handsome, so I'll use it as the first letter in the word handsome. Oh, what a great invention, this H. Oh, it's absolutely perfect, as useful as controlled capital letter H. Well, maybe it could use a smidge more work. Come home, H, come home!
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
I never tell sheep jokes. Oh, sheep jokes. Oh, hi, all. Kermit the Frog here, speaking to you from the meadow where we're going to talk to Ms. Little Bo Peep, whom has lost her sheep and doesn't know where to find them. Is that right, Ms. Peep?
Oh, yes, Mr. Frog, that's true. I don't know where to find them.
Well, do you have any clues as to where these sheep might be, Ms. Peep?
Well, yes, I know that if I leave them alone, they'll come home wagging their tails behind them.
Behind them.
That's my only clue.
That's the clue,
behind
folks.
Them.
Behind them, okay.
Yes.
Well, I think you certainly know what you're looking for. Matter of fact, Ms. Peep, here comes the sheep now. Maybe this is your sheep.
Where?
Over here.
My sheep! Oh, that's not my sheep.
That's a very strange-looking sheep there.
That sheep is wagging his tail in front of him, not behind him. Oh, I'll never find my sheep. Never.
Well, never say never, Miss Peep. Matter of fact, here comes another sheep now.
Where?
Over this way.
Oh, my sheep! Oh, joy, oh, joy, they've returned. Oh, it's my sheep. Wait a minute, that's not my sheep. That sheep's wagging his tail on top of him, not behind him.
Yeah, it's a very strange-looking sheep. Nothing personal.
I'm never going to find my sheep.
Oh, well, don't cry about it. Matter of fact, here comes another sheep, Peep. Over here.
Oh. Is it? Could it be? Oh, my God. Oh, no. Look at that.
Mm-mm.
Look at that. That sheep has no tail at all.
No tail.
Oh, my. What am I going to do? My poor lost little sheep.
Oh, dear. if your sheep would come. No, this way, ma'am. Over there.
Oh.
Oh, look at that tail wagging there.
Oh, my own lost sheep who wagged their tails behind them. Uh-huh. Oh, you're coming back to me at last.
Hey, get your grubby mitts off me, lady. Hmm? Who do you think you are?
Why, I'm Bo Peep. You're my sheep, don't you remember? Leave them alone and they'll come home wagging their tails behind them.
Hey, wait a minute. Hold on just a doggone minute. Hmm? I don't know nothing about this, but I'm not your sheep, Miss Bo Peep.
You're not?
You're not?
No, I'm not.
Well, who are you then?
Yeah, who are you?
Well, I'm Mary's lamb, and I'm late for school, so take it easy.
Oh.
See you later, alligator.
Oh. Not an alligator, I'm a frog. Well, this is Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News. Stay tuned for further bulletins on Miss Peep's sheep.
Out of the sheep meadow for an update on the Bo Peep story.
Yes, this is Kermit the Frog, and we understand that little Bo Peep has indeed found her lost sheep, and here he is now.
It's not true.
Bo. I'm
a
sheep.
I'm a sheep.
I'm wagging my tail.
Will you get out of here?
I am wagging my tail.
He is wagging his tail behind him.
Will you get out of here?
This
is Kermit the Frog returning you to your regular program. I don't believe this. I don't believe it. Will you guys get out of here? What happened to the sheep?
H is a nice letter. Isn't it nice and simple? Two lines with a line across the middle. It is the first letter in a word which we use often. The word? Hello?
Hello, is Harold there?
There's no one here by that name. The word hello begins with an H. Hello?
Hello, is Harold there?
There's no one here by that name. Hello is a word that we should use politely each time we answer the phone.
Hello, this is Harold. Do I have any calls?
Oh. Hi. That's okay. You've got good news in a letter? You're all excited? About what? Oh, an old friend? From Vermont. He's coming here? He's going to stop off? Oh, you're going to spend some time together. Great. Don't do it very often? Oh, that's wonderful. How? He's coming here today? No kid. Have I seen him? I don't know. What does he look like? His wavy blonde hair, blue eyes, sort of stocky. How tall? About that tall? I think that's who she was waiting for. Ed?
Hi, I'm Bob.
Bob, right. Good to see you. Okay, I'll see you later. Good. Bye.
Hi, Bad News. You say you want to make the swim team and you need our help? Well, hold on tight. Everything's gonna be all right. I'm Billy Joel Jive, super crime fighting ace. Me and my partner, Smart Susie Sunset, are on the case.
We caught up with Bad News Barton at the gym where he was trying out for the swim team.
Okay, Bad News. Get in there with the others. Let's see you do your stuff. Okay. On your mark, get set. You better try out for the wrestling team. Swimming isn't your style.
Bad News, I've got an idea which will help you make the team. What did you have for lunch this week?
Well, on Monday I had 10 candy bars, and on Tuesday I had 4 apple pies, and today I had 6 chocolate brownies, 3 candy bars, and 2 apple pies.
Now, Bad News, you want to make the swim team, don't you?
Right.
And to make the team, you got to lose some blubber. Right?
Right.
Apple pies, candy bars, and brownies are no way to lose blubber. What you've got to do is change your eating habits. You have to eat more fruit, nuts, and vegetables, as well as milk and meat.
You know, Sunset, we haven't seen Bad News for 3 weeks. I wonder how he's doing with his new diet.
Isn't that Bad News coming down the street?
This apple sure is good. Hey, I made the swim team, and look, no more candy bars, brownies, and apple pies.
Well, another case wrapped up by the great team of Sunset and Jive.
Oh, it's time for my favorite radio program. Mm-hmm. I think.
Good morning. Welcome to Get Moving, your favorite morning exercise show.
That's it.
This morning, our first exercise is going to be bending over and touching the toes.
Hey, everybody, why don't you do this with me? Just do what I do, okay?
Ready, begin. Okay. One, two, one, two, one.
Okay, bend over and touch your toes, kids.
One, two, one,
two. Oh, this is fun.
One, two,
three,
one, two, one.
I could do this all day.
One, two.
I hurt.
Hi, Ernie.
Ernie,
what?
Ernie, what are you doing?
Doing exercises,
Bert.
Are you doing exercises?
Why don't you join us?
No, thank you. No. I'm waiting for my favorite radio program, Pigeons in the News.
Well, Bert, why don't you do this exercise until
two.
Until it starts.
One.
No, thanks.
Two,
I think I'll just watch you.
Two. And ready. Stop. One. Two. Very good.
Wasn't that fun, Bert? Oh, you didn't do it,
all
did you?
All right.
No.
Now
okay.
For the
Where'd
next
you do this
exercise.
One? I don't want to.
Jumping up and down.
Jumping,
everybody.
Everybody
jump. Ready.
Okay.
Begin. And jump, jump, jump,
wow.
Jump.
Come on, Bert.
Jump, jump.
Oh, this
jump,
is fun.
What do you call
jump,
that?
Jump. This is jumping, Bert.
Jump,
jumping.
Jump, jump.
How do you do
jump,
it?
Jump. Just jump,
yeah.
Bert.
I don't know
yeah.
if I can
oh,
do that.
Fun.
That's
jump,
too exciting
jump,
for me.
Jump, jump.
What, like
jump,
this?
Jump, jump, jump.
Oh, nice, Bert.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Isn't that fun?
Yeah.
Jump. Jump.
Everybody jump in.
Jump.
Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump. Jump.
Okay, so long, Bert.
Jump. Jump.
And now
jump,
the pigeons
jump,
in the new.
Who cares?
Richmond,
jump,
Virginia,
jump,
40
jump,
pigeons attended
jump,
an unveiling
jump,
of a new
jump,
statue
jump,
of Robert
full, Bert.
E. Lee.
Jump, jump.
And now,
jump,
who
jump,
goes
jump,
in the
jump,
new?
Jump.
Good morning, Doctor.
Fine. That's safe, sir.
just take a listen to your heart. That's good. Did you ever hear it beat? It's making a nice sound now. It's going boom, 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 boom. You take nice deep breaths for me now. Let's take your blood pressure. Is this on your arm? You remember what this is like. I just have to pump it up, and when it comes back down, we take it off. Hold the thermometer under your tongue. It's 99. That's not bad. Open your mouth real big. Give me big ah.
Ah.
Give me big ah.
Ah.
Another big ah.
Ah.
And let me see those pretty eyes. Just keep looking straight ahead. Good. John, now we're going to test this eye. Just read the letters for me.
ZNB. H. P. F. H.
Oh, that looks fine. Let's try this one.
That's good.
Hey, we're going to test your hearing. Every time you hear the beep, you raise your hand. And let me feel your tummy. Does that hurt? Good. And how about over here? No, that's fine. Take a deep breath and hold it for me. Good.
Why would anyone throw a chair like that away for? Why, some people have no taste at all. This would be perfect for my living room if I could only get it inside. I need some help here.
Yeah, it went so much better than I expected, you know, after this morning. Yeah.
Hey, what kept you so long?
What?
You talking, Dad?
I haven't got all day, you know.
What are you talking about?
Well, how about getting this chair into my can here, huh?
You want us to put this chair into your can?
What, is there an echo out here, sunshine?
Look,
didn't
okay.
I just say that?
Look, let's just do it and get it over with, okay?
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's the spirit. I'll right, go inside, and you just
out.
Pass it in.
Okay, all right, watch out. Watch yourself.
All right, send it in.
Okay, wait. No, it won't fit.
Let's try it upside down.
Upside down?
Okay. Yeah.
Well, hurry it up.
Okay,
send
wait
it
a minute.
Down. Harry,
oh,
that's
okay.
It.
Honey,
wait,
this
no, let's,
way.
If we angle it a little
no,
bit.
No, honey, it's too
it
big
won't
for
fit.
The opening. It's not going to go in there.
Okay, sorry.
What's the big idea?
Oscar,
why don't you put it in?
The chair is too big. It just won't fit in there.
You give up too quickly.
Oscar, well, we tried it several different ways. The chair is too big for the opening of your trash can.
I'll bet there's one way you didn't try.
What?
just pick it up again. This will work. Now hold it up in front.
Pick it up.
But Oscar...
Oscar, it's too big.
It's not going to fit.
Just
like
hold
this.
It up. Now, when I say three,
yeah.
I want you to let it go.
Let
okay?
it go.
Let it go. How
but Oscar, no. That,
one,
that
two, three. Now it'll fit.
Now it'll fit.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
But Oscar, it's not much of a chair anymore.
But it looks better than it did before.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me. Excuse me. Oh, no, excuse me. Excuse me. My glasses. See you later.
Let's go get some honey. Bees make honey from nectar. Nectar is the juice they collect from flowers.
I see a bee there. I see two bees there. It's full of bees. And there's one.
You have to be careful around bees. Sometimes they sting. Beekeepers wear protective clothing. Honeybees live together in a hive. Mm-hmm. beekeeper's smoke pot keeps the bees quiet. Then the beekeeper can take out the honeycombs. You can eat honey right from the honeycomb. Or you can squeeze it from the comb with the honey press.
Let me see. Under the present Dewey Decimal System, this book belongs...
Wow! Look at all these books! Me never seen so many books before! Oh, yeah, right.
Quiet, please!
I did not see wastebasket.
All right.
Excuse me, sir. Sir? Could you tell me what you're doing with all these books here?
Why, this is a library. Yes, people come here to borrow books they'd like to read.
Oh, that's terrific.
Hmm.
This library.
Yes.
Oh, well, that's great because me try hard to read.
Oh, that's very good.
Yeah.
Now, what can I get you?
Well, me want a book about Little Red Riding Hood.
All right.
And one box of cookies, please.
Maybe you don't understand. You see, this is a library.
Yeah?
Yes, we have books here. Only books. We have no cookies.
Oh.
You understand?
Me see. Okay.
Right.
Okay. Then let's see. Me take book of nursery rhymes.
All right.
And a box of cookies, please.
We don't have cookies. We only have books. Just books. No cookies. All right?
Oh, yeah, right, got it now, okay. Then, let's see, me take a picture book.
Picture book?
Yeah, and a box of cookies.
How many times do I have to tell you we don't have cookies? Only books.
Oh, okay.
Just books,
okay.
No cookies.
Okay, no get upset, okay? Don't get excited, me not fussy.
Right.
Just give me a box of cookies.
No! We don't have cookies! No cookies! Just books! That's all! No cookies! Understand? Just books! Books!
You know what? Me get feeling you only have books?
That's right! Just books!
Me got it now. Okay.
All right.
Good.
At last.
Good.
Now, what do you want?
Me want book about cookies.
Fine. That we have. A book about cookies. Good.
And a glass of milk, please. A book about cookies and a glass of juice?
You're in back of me.
Oh, yeah? Well, you're in back of me if you really want to know.
No. I'm in front.
You're in back of me.
How's the weather back there?
I wouldn't know because I'm in front.
Your mistake. You're in back.
No, I'm in front.
No, you're in back.
Oh, yeah? Well, look who's back there.
You can follow me because I'm in front.
No, I'm in front.
No, you're in back.
How can that be? Because I'm in front of you.
Wrong again, Mac. I'm looking back at you.
Oh, ho. The front is up here.
Nope. Back.
No, front.
Back.
Front.
Back.
Back.
Front.
No, front.
Front.
Back.
Front.
Back.
Back.
Front.
Front.
Oh, come on, front.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
9 nails.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
9 lights.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Nine mice.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
9 quarters.
1, 2, that's the song of the count. I count the spiders on the wall. I count the cobwebs in the hall. I count the candles on the shelf. When I'm alone, I count myself. Oh, yeah. I count slowly, slowly, slowly getting faster. Once I start in counting, it's very hard to stop. Faster, faster, it is so exciting. I could count forever, count until I drop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, I love counting, whatever the amount. 1, 2, 3, 4, hey, yeah, 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 hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, that's his song.
All right,
Marvin. Let's see how smart you are.
Okay, Ralph.
Now, what would happen if you didn't have a mouth?
I couldn't talk.
Right, right. And what if you didn't have a nose?
I couldn't smell.
Right again. Now, Marvin, what would happen if you didn't have any ears?
I couldn't see.
Exactly. What do you mean you couldn't see if you didn't have any ears?
My hat would fall down over my eyes.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Couldn't hear either, for that matter. Hey, where are you going?
The what? Oh, the mirror game? Oh, mirror game? Do you want to play a mirror game with Ed and Linda?
Yeah.
Do you remember that game, mirror game? You have to do everything exactly as the other person does, just like you were looking in a mirror at your reflection. So whatever they do, you have to do. Okay, why don't you show us first? Ed and Linda will do it first. Okay, watch them closely. See if they do everything that the other person does. That's good. Go out to try it. Ralph?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Very good. Who else wants to try it? Okay, you want to try it, Danielle? Danielle, why don't you try it with Linda first, okay? See if you can do everything Linda does. Great. You stand up.
Okay.
Very good. Good, good. Do you want to try it, Zoe? No, okay. You want to try it with Linda? Okay, you try it with Linda.
One brightly beaked bird. Two brightly beaked birds. Three brightly beaked birds. Four brightly beaked birds. Five brightly beaked birds. Six brightly beaked birds. Seven brightly beaked birds. Eight brightly beaked birds. Nine brightly beaked birds. 10 brightly beaked birds. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. No brightly beaked birds.
Hey, Jerry!
Hey, Frank, is that you?
Me. How are you?
Yeah, good. How are you?
Oh, good. Long time no see.
Yeah, why don't you come on over here? We'll talk.
Well, gee, Jerry, it looks like a far way to go there, you know?
Yeah, it is pretty far.
I think it's too far. Tell you what, I got my tape measure here. Yeah? What I'll do is I'll measure how far it is between you and me.
Hey, I got a better idea.
What's that?
If you got your tape measure there, why don't you just measure it and see how far it is between you and me?
Sounds good, Jer. Yeah. Sounds good. Okay. What I'll do is I'll measure it, see?
Yeah.
And if it's too far, then I won't be able to come and talk to you.
Forget about it then.
Sure, sure. Okay, I'll tell you what you do.
Yeah?
Take the end of this tape measure. Just hold the end of the tape measure there. You got it?
No, I see. Oh.
Okay, good. Now, what I'll do is we'll measure it. We'll just stretch it out and measure it, you see?
Yeah.
And can you hear me all right?
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, yeah,
good,
I've got the tape measure here.
Yeah, I've got the tape measure. What we'll do is stretch it out right here.
Well, going back as far as you were before.
Right, it's about there, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
What'd you say?
It says, 37 feet.
37 feet?
Yeah, is that too far?
That's too far.
Okay, let go. Well, sorry about that. It's too far to walk to see you.
Maybe next time.
Maybe next time. My best to the kids and family.
Okay.
Sorry it's too far to walk.
Okay, go on.
Looks like the mother bird is about to have a baby. Look how all the birds just sit around and wait for their babies.
Uh-oh, babies.
What they doing? What is that cat doing?
Uh-oh, drinking some milk. A cow.
Mother's feeding her. See?
Baby lion.
Yep. Yeah. It's all drinking milk.
Drinking milk from his mother.
Right. Look at here. What's she doing?
Want me to wash his ears? Oh, no.
And the lioness? Now look how they clean.
Great kangaroo.
What's she doing? Washing his ears?
Yeah.
Do baby kangaroos carry babies in their pouches?
Mm-hmm.
Don't. What they doing, having a piggyback?
A baby kitten.
They have a lot of ways to take care of their babies, don't they, Scooter?
Baby hippo.
You know that hippopotamus is bigger than you. Now look at him.
Fighting.
And that's like you and your brother when y'all get to fighting. Look, they're he's sucking his finger.
Well, sucking his stump.
Some babies look just like their mother, only not so tall. Look how graceful that swan is.
Look at that little duck.
See that little baby swan?
Uh-huh.
It'll have to grow before it can look like its mother.
Oh, no. Look at that baby one.
But all babies know exactly who their mothers are.
Exit. 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 Exit.
Your old pal Grover.
Yeah.
Yeah. And do you know what I have here?
Yeah.
What?
A sign.
And do you know what that sign says?
Yes.
What?
Exit.
Exit.
Yeah.
That is very good because you read it upside down. That is even more difficult. Exit. Exit. What does exit mean?
It means that you go out a door that says exit.
You go out the door that says exit.
Yeah.
Do you ever come in the door?
No.
No?
No.
Oh, there are chickens in the trees. There are chickens in the trees. Won't you listen to me, please? There are chickens in the trees.
Excuse me, old pig. I couldn't help but overhear you. Would you mind singing that song again, please?
Why, not at all. Oh, there are chickens in the trees. There are chickens in the trees. Won't you listen to me, please? There are chickens in the trees.
You know, that's a very nice song, but you've got it quite wrong. I happen to be a professional chicken, and I know for a fact that chickens don't live in trees.
Is that so?
Absolutely. The very idea is utterly ridiculous. Quite ridiculous. Chickens in the trees, indeed. What will they think of next?
Okay, fellas, you heard what the rooster said. Everyone out of the tree.
Oh, you going to the park for the swings? Good. Have a good time.
Bye.
See you later. Bye-bye. Have a good time. Don't swing too high. Bye.
Oh, no.
What's wrong, Big Bird?
Rats.
What?
Well, I missed it all, right? I mean, Linda and Ed were teaching everybody a new game, I heard, and I wanted to learn how to play.
Oh, that's no problem. I can teach you, Big Bird.
You can, Bob?
Yeah, of course. It's very simple.
Really?
You want to learn?
Sure, what's the game?
Okay, it's called Mirror.
Mirror?
Yeah. It's all you have to do is do everything that I do, Big Bird. It's like looking at yourself in a mirror, the reflection in a mirror.
Yeah.
Okay, so whatever I do, you do exactly the same thing.
Oh, really? So I just do whatever it is you do.
Right.
But no matter what it is?
Everything I do. For instance, like if I scratch my head, you'll... Yeah.
Then I scratch my head.
You scratch your head.
Oh, good. And this is going to be fun, so I'll do everything you do, Bob.
You do everything that I do, Big Bird.
Okay.
I'll stand up here so we can do all kinds of stuff.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I'll do everything I do.
I will do everything, Bob.
Try and do it at the same time if you can.
Okay. When do we begin, Bob?
Right now.
Oh, good.
Okay.
Good.
That's very good.
That's very good.
Okay, it's... I'm finished.
I'm finished.
It's your turn.
It's your turn.
I mean... You lead.
You lead.
You start
you
now.
You start now.
I'll follow you.
I'll follow you. No,
I want you to do it.
I want you to do it.
Your turn.
Your turn.
This is ridiculous.
This is ridiculous. Ridiculous.
You know what I'm doing with this letter H? Let me show you. With the letter H, I can make words like hat and horse. And H can make me feel like a hero. Whoa! He's easy. Another H word is hold.
How about heave?
It's hot today. Hey, guys, why don't you cooperate? No, not like that. I said cooperate. Right. Have a nice day.
bottle. They made new bottles out of old bottles.
Hi, Howard.
Hello, Harold.
This is the letter H.
I'm aware of that.
Name some words that begin with this letter.
Hey. Heavy. Huge. Hard. Hop. Hurts. Hopeless. Help!
Congratulations. Hey, heavy, huge, hard, hop, hurts, hopeless, and help all begin with the letter H.
Hooray!
Howdy, partners. How'd you like to play a little guessing game? You would? Well, great. Okay, forgetful, we're ready.
Ready for what?
For our guessing game.
What guessing game?
Oh, the one we're about to play, forgetful. I'm going to give everyone some clues, and they're going to have to guess what you're going to be doing.
Oh!
Yes!
What am I going to be doing?
If I told them, forgetful, then they wouldn't have to guess, would they?
Well, guess what?
Take a step over there, forgetful.
What over here?
Over there.
Oh. Okie dokie.
Good.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Whoa!
And there's our first clue. Cause whoa is something you usually say when you're doing what forgetful's doing.
Get me off!
And that's another clue. Because if he wants to get off, that must mean he's on top of something.
Will someone stop this animal?
And there's still another clue. Forgetful is on an animal. But don't you start guessing yet, because I still want to give you a couple of more clues about this animal.
Will you stop kicking those legs?
Legs, that's a good clue. Because the animal Forgetful's on has four legs. Now be patient. I know you're dying to make a guess, but I still want to give you another clue.
Whoa, I'm slipping off the saddle.
Saddle? Oh, that's an excellent clue. Because the animal Forgetful's on usually wears a saddle for people to sit on. And now it's time to guess. What do you think Forgetful is riding on?
Get me down.
Well, if you said Forgetful's riding on a horse, you're absolutely right. Forgetful is riding on a horse.
Oh, stop, horse. Stop. Clemmy, turn him off.
What did you say, Forgetful?
I said turn him off.
Say that again.
Turn him off.
Okay. Well, Forgetful, you did it.
It did what, Clemmy?
Well, you held on till the very end. And that means you win the prize.
Prize? What prize is that?
Another ride.
Oh, no, that's okay, okay. We don't... No, Clemmy! No! Horse! No!
He's such a good rider. Makes me mighty proud just to watch him.
One, two,
three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Nine ants. Nine.
Big Bird, would you stop this? Oh. Hey, Bob. You know, I don't want to hurt your feelings, but, you know, I'm getting awfully tired of this game. I've done everything you've done for a long time now, and if you don't mind...
Big Bird, that's what I've been trying to tell you for the last 3 hours.
Oh, don't cry. Hey, we'll play it again sometime. We can play it now if you want.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G and H and by the number 9. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Fun, huh, Bob?